G'day, I'm Clive and welcome to CDP Outdoors. What we're looking at today is the small Toke's titanium wood burning stove again, but this time we'll be cooking some bacon and eggs on it to show you how it's not only for boiling water. As I showed in the previous video about it, it all fits in the 750ml pot. Again, to make it easier for me, I've cut a load of wood up and I've stored it in the little stove on my way, not too tight, so there's still room for the air to come through. So let's put that, and as you can see here, this is the feed hole, which we'll be using to feed extra fuel in as needed. I bought some of my homemade fire starters. Experimenting here, so there's something new or slightly different I've done, so let's see if it works any better. Put one of these down the bottom. These are just your normal barbecue fire lighters. So I'll just shove a couple of them in there. Couple of homemade ones. And as you can see, I've got a tin of mini Inferno here. But I don't think I'll be needing them. I hope I won't be. So they'll be for another video. These actually put your petroleum gel on, or the Vaseline, and I put it in the oven on a low heat for about 5 minutes so it all melted and soaked into the pads. So I'm just hoping that works a little bit better than just putting it on the outside and rubbing it in. On my walk in this morning, I was picking up some kindling as I went. Let's get this going. Wind dies down. That's caught so quick, which is good. And as I said in the previous video, they call it a gasifier stove. So once it gets burning properly, it'll draw the air in down below, draw it up, it'll burn that, which will give you a cleaner flame, and it'll also burn the smoke, they say, twice. I cleared the ground when I got here. It's normally covered in leaves and small twigs, but Like I said, I've cleared it to make it safer, reduce the chance of any fire spreading further than the actual wood stove itself. Just trying to make these thicker pieces of twigs now. In the bottom of the stove, like I said, I cut up some wood, and it's some firewood from home, and it's a jarrah, which is a hard wood. So once that gets going, we should have a pretty decent little stove going. Okay, where am I today? I'm on the just off the Bibbulmun Trek, not far from the Mundaring Weir, and it's winter at the moment, so there's no fire bans on, as long as it's sensible, all will be good. It's a beautiful spot here in Western Australia. A couple of months ago, when I came to do some filming here, there was an emu came just trotting around the shelter, around the camp. I did try putting an egg in, it's supposed to be an airtight container, but it got out. So it'll be a scrambled egg, and I've got some bacon there chopped up. And the frying pan I'll be using is the Topes Titanium, and it's their smallest one. I think it's about 115mm across. It sits just nice on top of this. I am looking at getting the largest one, which I think is 145mm, which will be a lot easier when I'm cooking stuff. Give them some nice heat. And if you're wondering what hammock I've got behind me, it's the Hennessy hammock, their Expedition Zip one. And I've just brought it out today to find out if I could get the hammock gear and the quilt to fit on it nice. So I'll be jumping in that later, but it looks like I've worked it out just by tying it one of the D-rings on the underquilt to the O-ring on the pull-out point of the hammock. So let me go and get some water. I want to get this going properly, I'll make a coffee. And the lid to the frying pan is off the 1100mm Topes pot. Doesn't fit that way. It'll sit on there nice, but it seems to fit snug upside down. So what I might do is get a second one and see if I can just get this swapped around onto the opposite side, or even send an email to Topes saying, can you do it that way around for us? So we've got a lid for the frying pan then. My coffee's not the best, but they're better than nothing. Let's feed this fire a little bit more to make sure it's going. The important thing about a little wood stove is before you start throwing your pots on, make sure you've got it established, because there's nothing worse than taking your pot off to keep stoking it up and blowing it, and really just wasting fuel then, because your cup's not on the stove making your coffee. This is quite a popular shelter on the Bibbulmun Trek down there, Ball Creek. because it's rather close to a car park. It's about 2.6 kilometres away, which is about 2 miles-ish. So it's an easy walk in. It takes on average about 35 minutes to get in here. There's a couple of advantages of the wood burning stove. One, you don't really need to carry your fuel with you because you can pick it up along the way. And two, if you've got any paper or stuff that you are able to burn, just throw it in and it's less for you to carry out. And like I said before in the other video, that the smallest pot or mug I can get to fit on this is the 550ml, and it doesn't come with any trivets that go across the top, so you can put a smaller pot on. Or they don't make it or make any or sell them for it. Yep, that's my coffee water done. Let's get that off. Not a stove if you're in a hurry. If you want to just relax and you don't mind fiddling, yeah, it'd be good for you. It's starting to sizzle. Now, I didn't bring a windshield on purpose. I wanted to see how it would work on a fairly windy day like today. Seems to be doing okay so far. I'm not disappointed, so. smell you get from cooking outdoors. The smell of the bacon cooking and the wood burning underneath. And what adds to the flavour when you come to eat it, makes it more enjoyable. I think it's time to drizzle the egg in there now. So there's actually two eggs. Should have bought some butter, but I have to stop sticking. Well, that to me looks like it's cooked. So I'll let the fire burn down. There you go, it's my morning coffee and bacon and eggs. And there's no cafe in sight. Tastes bloody good. Right, this is the Topes small titanium wood burning stove. It'll do the job. It takes some work to keep it going. But as you saw, I've made a coffee, I've cooked some bacon and eggs. And I'm enjoying them. And I've got a little heat source, which really only cost me the price of the stove to buy, and fuel from now on will be free. So I hope you've enjoyed the video, and if you have, please hit that like button down below and share it with all your mates. And if you're new to my channel and you have enjoyed the video, hit that subscribe button and the bell button next to it so you can be notified of all future videos. And if you're already one of my subscribers, I thank you very much. So, until next time, get out there, have some fun, and take care.